What made him this way? What is the attraction? What keeps us fascinated? This is the story of Chris Chan. On November 5th, 2009, Christian uploaded a video of himself performing what he believed to have been 51 bicep curls using a 12-pack of lemonade cans in each hand. He claimed that the makeshift dumbbells weighed 50 pounds each, when in fact, they were closer to 10 pounds. As with his earlier push-up video, Chris performs the exercise incorrectly, giving his muscles very little actual workout, and would have been dangerous if tried using heavier weights. Nevertheless, he begins sweating profusely very early on in the video, straining to lift the cartons. During the workout, some cans fall out, so Chris stops briefly to reinsert them.
51 and 51! Ah! What a workout. I'm strong.
Later that day, he uploaded another video in which he finally reveals the complete photo he had been using cryptically to blackmail Clyde Cash. The visual content of the video itself is thought to be lost.
I have run out of good humor, so now it's time for the terrible. There's the picture. Ugh. Disgusting.
Chris then uploaded his third and final video of the day, in which he apologizes for the way he behaved during his phone conversation with Casey's father the previous night.
Casey? I'm sorry about the way I acted on your father last night. I realized that I could have been more respectful and said, yes sir, and just stick with that. And I realize now that some of the things he talked to me about, some of the talked down to me about, were like, yeah, definitely things I should be working on. And I promise I will get an office job. And I will make efforts to move out of my house, even though I'll probably end up with this house inheriting it. But anyway, Casey, I love you so much. I care about you. It just made me feel sad at the end of that phone call. You know, it said some of the things your father said. It was just shots in the heart. Let me cry. I'm not afraid to cry in front of you. Casey, I need you. I love you. You're the best thing in my life. You're the best person that's ever come into my life. You know more than I do. I need you, Casey. I care about you so much. I just can't fight the feeling. I love you. I love you. I need you. Please don't leave me. Please don't be mad at me. I made mistakes. But a man admits when he is wrong. And I was wrong in the way I acted last night. I'm very, very sorry I hurt your feelings. I would feel terribly sad if you went back to that other Chris. Please don't mean me. I love you. You need me as well because I am an honest and very loyal person. And unlike the other Chris, I don't go all that crazy. I stay sane most of the time. And even when I try to act crazy, those are pretty much lame attempts. Anyway, you know me, I am strong. I'm strong-willed. I would do whatever I could in my power for you. Everything. And I will hold up to my promises. Just all the other things came up. But I don't need excuses. It's not about excuses. I'm gonna uphold my promises, Casey, and I don't want you to leave me. Please. I love you. And I need you. I'll talk to you later. Hopefully. I pray.
Captain's Log, Stardate, November 6, 2009.
Liquid Chris uploaded a video in which he states that Casey's father has given him his blessings to pursue his daughter.
I just want to say that Casey's father has bestowed upon me his blessings to marry and hanky-panky with his daughter, sweet Casey.
And also shows a page on the United States Copyright Office website, which states that the copyright for Sonichu as a 2D digital artwork has been claimed by Christian Weston Chandler. This was in fact true, but the Copyright Office does not check whether the applications for copyright are infringing, and the approval process is near automatic, with claims awarded to anyone who pays the necessary $45 fee, like Christian did. Copyright registration is also not an official recognition of copyright. It was around this time that Christian completed a special one-off five-page comic made for Casey, which would become known as Sonichu Special 4. The story itself is largely a copy of the Rescuing Casey level, which he had made in Little Big Planet, and also borrows a few references from the 1991 action film Terminator 2, Judgment Day. Christian drives his car at the maximum speed limit of 65 miles per hour to rescue Casey from Liquid Chris. When he arrives, Liquid tries to attack him with a knife, but Christian dodges his slashes. He then grabs hold of Liquid and kicks him in the back, bringing him to the ground. Christian then whips out his Megatron pistol, which was featured in some earlier videos, and shoots Liquid Chris in the shins, announcing, "You'll live, but never impersonate or lie that greatly ever again." He then brings Casey safely back home to her parents, who congratulate him. Christian and Casey kiss, and onlookers praise Christian and insult Liquid Chris. He sent the comic to Casey for consideration. After she had read it, Christian called her, asking for her opinion.
Hi, Casey. How are you?
I'm okay.
Yeah. So, did you get the comic pages I sent you?
Yeah, I'm a little disturbed by the violence in it. You shot Chris.
Only in the legs, so he wouldn't chase after us.
But that's horrible! That's really horrible. Like, he'd be in a wheelchair. Like, he wouldn't do that to you. He's a lot nicer than that. You're trying to make yourself look better than him, but you shot him.
Well, pretty much Jim coming after me with a knife.
It's like, why did you have to make it so violent? Like, normally in your comics, you, like, transform into Christian Sonichu and beat them that way. Like, I've never seen you, like, attempt to kill somebody in a comic before.
I mean, I just feel like I should be more, I don't know, more realistic and these pages, because it's more close to real life.
So you're saying that you would shoot him in real life?
Well, in self-defense. I mean, I would...
Where would you get a gun anyway?
Well, I do not currently own a real gun. I drew that gun based off Generation 1 Megatron.
I know, but you shot him with a real gun in the comic. Like... He was my boyfriend and you shot him. I mean, don't you think that I'd still care about him a little?
Well, it's not officially published yet. I mean, I can change that page. I can fix that.
But you already did it. The images are already in my head.
Well, yeah, okay. Yeah, I could have done it better. I could have done it less violent. I'm sorry.
If you were sorry, you wouldn't have done it in the first place. I mean, like, you drew him there... in pain, and you're just watching him bleed, and then you leave him. Like, what happens if you did that in real life? He'd die.
No, actually, I would have called 911 on him, you know. Bring the police and the ambulance around.
Okay, then you would be like, I shot him? They're going to arrest you. You're going to call 911 on yourself? I have no words to describe it. I mean, you did this after the thing with my father, and he told my brother about it and my sister about it. Like, my whole family is against you. They think you're crazy. What's going to happen if, like, somebody sees this? They're going to think you're insane.
Well, nobody else has to see it.
But what happens if they did? I don't get why you had to shoot my boyfriend. The hell? And
okay.
I mean,
okay.
And I was starting to believe in you again, even though you do all these things. Like, you never cleaned your room. You never made the song. You didn't stop eating fast food. Because I totally know about the whole McDonald's thing. And you still can't jog or work out or whatever. Just sit around and play video games. You haven't done anything you said you were going to do for me. And then you show a comic with you shooting people. And I'm just supposed to be like, yay, thank you?
You're right.
Besides, and I found out that you didn't even make that date level for me. I heard that you made it for another girl. That's so disrespectful. You won't do anything for me. Okay, yeah, you finally made the comic, but then, oh my God. I mean, you were so nasty to my family. You were just, you don't even seem apologetic at all. I mean, that whole video you made sounded so fake. It's like what my little sister does when she doesn't get her way. You just sound like a spoiled, retarded brat.
It was true. I cried. I did cry. I cried.
No, you didn't. There were no real tears.
No, those were real.
No, they were not. Don't raise your voice at me. Seriously, that is what Kara does when she doesn't get her way.
Those were real tears.
No, they weren't. I really think my dad's right. I think you just want me so you could fuck me and take me from Chris because you're jealous of Chris. And I mean, you, like, come on. You're lucky I gave you this much of a chance. First time you met me, all you did was stare at my chest and insult me.
No, I
can't understand how you call me fat, and then the other hand, you're, like, staring at me the whole time.
I was looking at your face. I stare at your face.
That, my face is not down there. I'm not that short.
No. I was looking at your face.
Let me pick up the phone here. Hey, who's this?
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, wait a minute. Is this who I think it is?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah,
Mr. Ian Brandon Anderson?
No, my name is Christian Weston Chandler. You know
no,
that.
No, it is not. My name is Christian Weston Chandler, and you are Ian Brandon Anderson. And you,
no.
What are you doing to talking to Casey?
She and I are friends, and my name is Christian.
Wait, which am I? Am I your girlfriend or your friend? You keep going back and forth. You're lying
friends.
Again.
You will only stay friends, Mr. Ian Brandon Anderson. That is as far as you go.
Look, Chris, I'm so sick of you calling me by that stupid name. I am the real deal.
Shut up.
I have all the proof and everything. You're the copycat.
No,
okay, who am I going to believe? The guy who's hot and sexy and can play a guitar? Or the person who lies to me every fucking night?
Yeah, and not to mention that he is fat and ugly.
I am not fat, goddammit!
Yeah, you are. You look like you weigh a good 220 pounds.
I do not weigh 220 pounds. I weigh a lot less than that.
You
weak little son of a bitch. I am
like,
so
you
sick.
Know, you
if you put me down
mine.
And call me all these insults to my face, and my name is truly Christian Weston Chandler, I'm so sick of you pretending to be me and pretending to have all the rights to everything of mine. What the hell have you had against me? That was like, that came up even before the year 2000.
Yeah.
What the hell, Chris? Why have you started doing this in the first place, you little son of a bitch?
I told you. I have not started doing anything. You did everything, Mr. Ian Brandon Anderson. When you decided to...
My name is Christian Weston Chandler, and I'll thank you to call me
that. Don't talk to my boyfriend like that, and don't curse around me.
I told you something. My name is Christian Weston Chandler, and it has been my God-given name my entire life.
You shut up. You shut up. You've been nothing but a pain to my side. And you've been nothing but a pain in the friendship to relationship between me and Casey.
Yeah, well, yeah, no, you would not even, you wouldn't have access to her if it was not for me, because if you hadn't been copying me this whole time, you would
have
never even
I have not been copying you! You have yeah, been copying me!
God, how naive, what relationship?
True. You are a liar and a fraud. You naive bastard.
No, you are the liar, you are the fraud. I am so sick of you putting me, of you call me all that when you know and I know and that everybody in the whole world knows that
Stop
you...
It.
You don't have the real true and honest fan
base. I am so sick of this.
Shut up. Yeah, you are just a worthless waste of life.
Oh, no, you are the worthless waste
no,
of life,
are.
Chris.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
I am doing something with my time, Mr. Anderson, except for just copying someone else. Stop it, charade. We already know you're a liar, Mr. Ian.
I don't care about being Christian Weston Chandler. Thanks for showing me. Care about me. You lied to me this whole time.
I have not been lying to you, Casey. God.
No, you have been. You've been lying to everyone on the internet.
I have not been lying to anybody. I have been honest and true.
You have not.
Well, hang on a second.
You are just a fraud. Your whole life is a fraud.
The one in the brown stripes who's taking Casey. I want you to talk to him and tell him off. I'm sick of calling him off. He can still call me the dead gun, Ian Brendan Harrison. You better still be there, because I'm going to have you talking to the real Robert Chandler in a second. Go ahead. Please, help me out here.
What's going on? You there?
Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
Hello?
Hello?
Who is this?
Casey?
This is Rob. She ain't saying anything, Christian.
Hello?
Casey, please, just listen. That's my father, Robert Chandler.
I know, I keep talking and he can't hear me.
Yes, he can't hear you.
He's saying hello.
What? What do you want?
I just want him to talk to them till that
Chris off. Well, right now it's midnight. What in the world do you want?
She don't want anything. Talk.
You don't want to talk either. She can't talk. Her cat's got her tongue.
Casey, please talk.
Sorry, I'm really confused. Like, one minute I'm talking to someone and the next minute I'm not.
All the men say you don't have to listen to them. Just hang up on the bitch.
I was trying to get y'all to talk to that Chris over there, because he's over there with her right now.
I don't care where they are. They might be lying to you.
He's still pretending to be me with this address.
Christian, just shut up and hang up on him. Take a sip if you're upset. Don't ever answer the phone when I call. That's your fault.
Yeah, hiding behind Daddy's skirt. That's what I thought.
Yeah, I like how I'm a bitch.
Oh, Chris, shut the hell up. Casey,
yeah,
I'm
you're
sorry.
Just, yeah,
I'll
I knew you
later.
Would. This entire time.
Chris, shut up.
No,
talk
shut up.
There,
Casey, are you with me? Are you with me or are you with him?
You? At least you're not calling me a bitch, because I find that extremely disrespectful.
No, that was my mom. That was my mom who said that.
Yeah.
Oh, good. My family hates you. Your family hates me.
Are you with me, baby? Are you with me? Are we going to get married?
Yeah, let's go get married, because I can't deal with this.
I can't deal with him still pretending to be me.
You are just a less worthy version of me.
You're calling everyone a liar when you're the biggest liar I know.
I am not a liar.
And then you're going to put your parents on here and your parents are going to insult me like that? What do you want me to do? What do you think I'm going to do? That's crazy. That's
just don't understand the situation.
Casey, are you officially
breaking
up with
Chris?
Liar. You're a bitch. You didn't even defend me. You were just like, talk to her, talk to her. What was I supposed to say? That was embarrassing. That's the first time your parents met me. That's what you wanted? Good job.
Okay. So are you officially
No.
Tell me, are you officially
broken
up with
him? Why do you need your parents to defend you? My parents would defend me.
Okay, well, listen, Casey, I'm sorry about that misunderstanding. I'll talk to you later. And that's for you, Christian Weston Chandler, over there. I am going to find you, and I am going to have you proven as the liar. Goodbye.
Oh, fuck you.
Baby.
That's great. It ended with Casey saying, oh, fuck you.
I can't. Oh my God, Barb called me a bitch. Oh my God. We know how much you love it when people call me a bitch.
Yeah, I know, right? Kind of rage right there. That was great.
Oh my God, that was the best call ever. I can't believe we got Barb and Bob.
I can't believe we got half the stuff we got.
No, Gecko, it was definitely a different voice that called me a bitch. That was definitely Barb who said, just hang up on the bitch.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
Okay, so back to Mumble.
Alright.
On November 8th, Liquid Chris uploaded a video showcasing Sonichu Special 4, ending with an illustration hinting at a marriage between Liquid and Casey. On November 10th, Chris had one final call with Casey, in which he grills him about his behavior and his future.
I mean, you're not even going to live to see 30. Why would I want to be with someone who I know is going to be dead in 4 years? 3 years? My family hates you. You're lying to me. You're nasty to my friends. You lie to my friends. I mean, don't think I don't know that you don't lie to Kim. Don't think I don't know you don't lie to me. I don't think you'd have luck with anyone to tell you the truth. So you cannot tell me that you want me to be with you or that you love me, because you're just going to die wasting your life playing video games and doing nothing. You've wasted your life and you think you're good enough to date anyone, including me? I mean, you're freaking weak-willed. You're not even good enough for society. I don't think you're ever going to get anything. You can't fight for what you want. You definitely didn't fight for me. So you know what? I don't need this at all. Fuck you. I don't even want to be friends. Because you are a total waste of space. And you know what? I'm getting married tomorrow, 2 p.m. And it's all thanks to you. Because if it weren't for you being such an ass, I wouldn't see what a great person Chris is. And how much he really does love me. Because I had someone to compare him to who doesn't give a shit about me. Who only loves his video games and himself. I don't even care. Because I don't even have anything to say to you. Because you know what? You won't hurt about this. You'll be over this by tomorrow. I will never see anything that shows that you're even hurt by this. Or you even care. I'm going to go ahead and get married tomorrow. I'm going to be happy, and I'm going to live my life. And you know what? You're going to be doing the same thing in 5 years. If you're not dead. I bet you I'll never be mentioned again by you. You're not going to be upset. You're not going to do anything. I bet you anything. I'm going to see a new video being like, oh, who the hell was Casey? I'm going after... I don't even care anymore. I don't care. So, have fun making a video about needing a new girlfriend. Because... I'm done. Peace out.
Soon after, Chris made a video expressing his sorrow.
Okay, see, I just let you know. Because you hung up when I was trying to say it. I'm sorry for hurting you and mistreating you. With a lot, with some lies. Mess it with honest truth. But, you know, that's fine. If you feel like your Chris will make you happy, that's fine. Congratulations on your wedding. I wish you and Chris all happiness in the world. I'll say prayer for you. For the wedding, a safe honeymoon. Guess so. See you around. Or talk to you again later. I guess. Another day. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. God bless you. And your sweet, gentle, caring person, tender, loving care, Katie. I love you.
The next day, Christian finally received his certificate of copyright registration for Sonichu and victoriously announced so in a video, with all signs of heartbreak seemingly gone, just as Casey had predicted.
It's no time for fan mail. Well, not much fan mail, as it is a little something from the Virginia Library of Congress. Let's take a look inside, shall we? What do you know? All the trolls have been lying after all. They have no registration. Read it and weep. But anyway, the signature, the seal, and the registration number, and the titles, and everything. This will be scanned and uploaded to the Wikipedia today. So, middle finger to you, you damn trolling bastards. You can die in rotten hell, Clyde. And you too, Chris. Sorry, Casey, but that's why some of a bitch ain't got nothing now. Oh, also something else, you know. Front and back. Information. So there. I am the man. I am the real creator. I am Christian Weston Chandler, birth name Christopher, Spanish nickname Ricardo, of Rockersville, Virginia, in the United States of America. Hail to the president. By God, there is a day. Okay, I don't know the words, but I'm being patriotic here. So everybody have a good day. And more stuff is to come. So keep it spinning and praying that you will get it. Have a great day. Catalog. Stardate, November 14th, 2009.
2 days later, Christian made a video addressing his Sonichu comic and falsified listings on the marketplace website, Craigslist.
I will hold true to my promise and upload a page at least, more if I feel like it that day, on a daily basis to Wikipedia, starting today. The current page for today will have been uploaded by the time this video is uploaded onto the Wikipedia. There I currently and have not had any ads on Craigslist selling anything or offering anything at the time. So anybody who sees such ads that pertain to my home address, my home number, mine or my mother or my father's names, please flag it as spam or something like that, because it's fake at the time. Unless I specifically say it's legit on the Wikipedia or here on this YouTube account, do not believe it. And also, I would like the phone number for getting contact with the people behind Craigslist so we can straighten out that mess and prevent frauds. And also, find on the final note, Kai Cash, I'm getting your information. I'm coming after you, man. I'm getting your information. I have a person on the inside. So you just fall back. Get off the internet, stay off the internet, son of a bitch. So anyway, I'll leave that with everyone, with y'all, and y'all have a safe, pleasant day. Thank you.
Later that day, Christian sent Vivian G an email hoping to settle past disputes and form a business partnership together. Now that I finally have peace of mind, I apologize for the past informalities and emotional outbursts in past communications. I have decided I will fully approve your continued audiobook videos and sales, but in return, I ask for 25% of all the money changed to USA currency you have and will have made from all that you have put together and sold, as well as 2 copies of each CD/DVD of the audiobooks and 2 of each other additional merchandise aside from the audiobooks. I extend an olive branch of peace, and I await your well-thought response. Have a good, safe day, Miss Vivian. Vivian swiftly replied, yeah, peace of mind. Peace of mind to fucking want me dead at least, what, 3 to 4 times now? You've cursed me like 17 times, and now you expect me to give you money? I fucking offered you months ago, and you just wanted me dead. Go fuck yourself. Love, Vivian. Christian apologized for his past actions and attempted to sweeten the offer. I would like to hire you to be my manager of business relations. Obviously, you have done something right with your wheeling and dealing to make the money from the audiobooks. Merchandise should be made official. I would like a list of all those who have created merchandise, web pages, contact info, and names, so I can get in touch with the ones who did well in their creations, not just ship-shot parodic crap, or locate some toy company's info for my reference. Phone conversations with the true people of Nintendo and Sega, and maybe Sony, would be beneficial, with assured assistance from my manager. It is time to set the merchandise wheels and legitimate business talks in motion. I have removed all curses from the past, and sent you forgiveness blessings. I've had the epiphany about business relations and matured mentally from that. Please help me. Vivian suggested that he contact Nintendo and Sony himself over the phone, and by sending them an 18-minute long video pitching Sonichu. She then gave him an exhaustive list of the structure and checklist for the pitch. Staying true to his promise, from the 14th to the 18th, Christian uploaded a new page of Sonichu episode 20 every day. However, on November 19th, he wrote a blog post on the Wikipedia, apologizing that he could not deliver a new page on that day, and informed his audience that he was working on a video presentation to offer to major companies, and also updated the website with a new category, the mailbag. This was a page designated for answering the many questions emailed to the sysop, CogsDev, addressed to Chris by so-called fans. Mailbag 1's questions and answers were posted on the 19th, but Christian chose to answer only the questions which were respectful, free of ridicule, and complimenting him. He also received an email from Vivian, berating him for his lack of effort in contacting companies about Sonichu. A couple of days later, he answered questions from Mailbag 2, and also created a rejected mailbag page, where he posted emails from trolls which he deemed unacceptable and unworthy of answering, possibly as a way to gain more sympathy, or perhaps set an example of what not to ask Christian. On November 23rd, he finally completed his video graphic presentation for Nintendo and Sega's consideration.
Hello there, business people! Welcome to the world of Quickville, Virginia, and the world of Sonichu and Roshu. Anyway, I'm here today to talk to you about the revolutionary little character that will make a lot of money because he's already been there and famous for almost 10 years now. His name is Sonichu. There's a little real electric hedgehog Pokemon right here. Yeah, first off, we have to look at my big book here. Look how thick that book is. So thick, I have to get another book.
He explains how he conceived Sonichu for a project in Manchester High School and summarizes how Sonichu came to be in the comic book storyline.
Now, Sonichu and Roshu's appeal. Yeah, mainly the appeal was aimed towards children. And that was the start of the books there. We got little toys here I put together. Even a board game where the board's right here. Sonic vs. Sonichu, a little racing type game, but it's a little bit Monopoly style with cards that you pick up. And shortcuts. Anyway. That is part of the merchandising thing that I plan on branching out with in the world of Sonichu eventually. Anyway, yeah, I got a whole bunch of history here. A whole lot of history. Upon, like, you know, from creation with to making it to a whole bunch of stories and whatnot. And even made a little title for it in my homemade Nintendo Power magazine, which I believe I told Nintendo of America about in a previous letter or two. Following this video, there will be a video where it will be presented live from my PC, a PowerPoint presentation that can better describe the situation. Anyway, with the comic books, I plan on drawing, at least in my lifetime, hopefully, between 50 to 100 books.
Chris highlights the allegedly worldwide appeal of the Sonichu franchise.
This Sonichu franchise, it has big number of fans. I even have number of fan submissions. Like, this here is a piece of fan art that came from a girl I knew in Australia, and that's a postcard sent from her right there. That's going to be the cover of the first book that's just based on Sonichu, which will definitely be after number 10, which this one will be the cover of. This one came from Zorekuzawald. That's his YouTube name. Yeah, also, you know, I've received fan art in the snail mail. Those are printed off the internet. Like this lovely one that came from a lovely one named Allie in Sun Valley, California. Thank you. Thank you very much. And from that, you know, that's, you know, she got that little bear, like, you know, Rosie's tail was wrong, but I'll forgive her. But still, through my own version of it. Isn't that fun? Oh, and plus, you know, local art in Charlottesville, an artist did a caricature of me. Anyway, yeah, very famous. Very, very famous. Yep. This one's just a fan letter from a Julian, Ohio. It's a little piece of fan art from somebody who's possibly Japanese, who lives here in Virginia. About that. But anyway, also aside from that, I have definitely made a set of my homemade Pokemon training cards, which I use, which I keep at home for art's sake. A whole lot of them here. This could definitely branch out in a very profitable thing, both for between Nintendo and Sega, and also with Sony, also possibly with Sony, with the animated show that maybe Cartoon Network and their people can help me out on when that TV show gets run. I will be the director and I will be voicing myself. And Sonichu, listen to the difference. Okay, this is me, Christian Weston Chandler, and this will be Sonichu. Hey, Roshi, let's go out and zap to the extreme. We got some bad guys to defeat. Come on, let's go. Yeah. A lot of fun. Anyway, running low on time. I'll show you the whole layout of the Quickville Shopping Center. I actually have all these printouts from my computer drafting class. Computer-aided design classes, but this is the last one right before I graduated from Piedmont Virginia College with my degree and certificate in computer-aided design. It's very good. I mean, I would just imagine this in real life. It would even have a Pokemon Center in there, like the one New York used to have before it turned into a Nintendo World USA. It should have stayed a Pokemon Center. Now, that was definitely better appeal than just Nintendo, even though, yes, Nintendo has the rights and everything, but it was the Pokemon Center. I mean, if the Quickville Shopping Center does get built, let's agree to put a Pokemon Center in it. And it has a mayor's office right here above the front of the main front entrance of the building, which is as portrayed in the comic book series. Anyway, I'll pretty much take care of it for this portion of the video. So the next video to follow this one will be the PowerPoint presentation. So I will be reading audio. I will be reading from that and pointing the camera towards the PC thing. So to Nintendo, Sega, and Sony, and all the other companies interested in franchising with me here, I await your call to my home phone number or my cell phone. Thank you very much, and have a pleasant day.
As another sweetheart saga drew to a close, Christian displayed a remarkable bouncing back of spirits, urging others to make the Sonichu franchise a dignified reality, like he had done for much of his adult life, which only reassured trolls that his life was a seemingly endless, repeating cycle, and that there was always room for another nemesis and another boyfriend-free girl to come along.